Did we have any choice in being here today? Or was it predetermined since the beginning of the universe that all of us would be here today, in this theater, thinking these exact same thoughts? In short, do we have any free will at all? In the Western tradition, Greek myth and literature examines this subject to great depth. It's a subject of fate and agency. And what I love about the Greek gods is they're not smarter than us, and they're not wiser, and they're certainly not more emotionally balanced, they're just more powerful. They're happy to smite someone or to make them fabulously wealthy, just to see what happens as they play with life. And the kinds of things they get up to are exactly the kinds of things we get up to when we play The Sims. But what's key is that in both cases, the mortals of the Greek gods and The Sims, they both have free will. They can both make their own choices. That's what makes it interesting. Here are some images from my Sims 3 game. So in my world, I have enormous power. I can make Peter Moore a fashion stylist, complete with Sims tattoo. All of his tattoos are real, by the way. I've seen them. And Dr. Ray Muzica from BioWare. He's a medical doctor, just like he is in real life. And I like to put myself in there as well. And I can live out my life in different ways and see if I'd taken a different path, what would have happened. So here's me trying out some different professions from the Sims 3 ambitions. I can be a firefighter. My favorite is the architect. You get to go around and make houses. I also ran some weird experiments, like what would happen if I made a town full of me, which sounds great. And it turns out, actually, all the Rod Humbles hated each other. So the whole town became this horrible, angry mess as they just fought in the streets. Actually, two Rod Humbles did get along. They got on really well. And what's wonderful about the simulator is that you get these unexpected emergent results. That's where all the magic is. Nature has this neat trick. It takes simple building blocks, then lets lots of them interact over long periods of time. You add a dash of randomness, and complex things emerge. The Sims uses this trick, and it gives really surprising results. So on the Sims team, even though we wrote the code of the Sims mind, and we know exactly how the Sims universe works, we try to predict a few simple things, like when would a Sim go out to eat? When would a Sim die? And we couldn't. No matter how much processing power we threw at the problem, once that simulator got running after a few ticks, it just became too hard for us to predict. In fact, the only way we could do it was to run an identical copy of The Sims, start at exactly the same time, and run it at a slightly higher speed. So in a very real sense, The Sims 3 has given The Sims free will. The way it works is that each Sim decides on courses of action available, and then The Sims' higher mind functions figures out which one it wants to do, and it weighs it by short-term needs, personality, and long-term goals. And the result is a very sophisticated ecosystem, which we found impossible to predict. Switching to the human mind for a second, before you think that's a little bit too simplistic, modern neuroscience has told us a lot more about how our free will works, and some of the results are very surprising. For example, Benjamin Libet's experiments measured when a subject's unconscious brain started warming up to move their hand, versus when the conscious mind first knew about it. The results were really surprising. The unconscious mind lit up 300 milliseconds before the conscious part of the brain did. Just think about that for a second. Your unconscious brain starts to get ready to move your hand before your mind says, I'm going to move my hand. So the implications of that are pretty worrying. Either our free will is a kind of veto mechanism, and it just says yes or no to the choices that our unconscious mind figures out ahead of time for us, or even worse, it's an epiphenomenon, similar to fire from a smoke or a jet trail from a plane. It's got absolutely nothing to do with the phenomenon. It's just a useless byproduct that we think is important. The Sims mind, by contrast, directly controls the Sims' actions. They may just have more free will than we do. Within the Sims studio, over the next few years, our aim is to nothing less than to expand the Sims through theme, time, and space. This October, we will be bringing this world to console with all new features that make it easier than ever to play with life and allow for even more control, connectivity, and creativity. We've never been able to cram as much of a robust world into a console before this year, and the powers of the next-gen high-def platforms really shine. It's quite an accomplishment. It's an incredibly sophisticated piece of software. Within each console, lives are lived, love is found and lost, and fortune smiles and scowls at each living thing. The dance between the player and the little world is a magical thing. They're alive in there.
Sometimes you fall down, can't get back up. We're hiding behind skin and it's too tough. How come we don't say I love you enough till it's too late? It's not too late.
So The Sims 3, this fall, on console, unlike anything we've ever done before. And as Rod likes to say, it's far more than a game, and I agree with him.